For piano and tuba, and we're going to have a look in this video on how we arranged it and what changes we had to make it playable on the instrument. So the bassoon is a very different instrument to what the tuba is. It's got a narrower sound, still sounds about the same register, or can play about the same register, tends to be a little bit higher than what this thing plays, but it's pretty simple. But the thing that the bassoon has is a lot perkier, so these opening lines. We'd come out just really nice and sharp and nice and crisp. And the tuba's got a bit of a fatter sound, so well, obviously I had to make concessions there for that, and it's just going to be a sound difference. What we did have to do though was alter the range of some of them. So we've transposed the whole piece. It was originally an F, and we brought it down to E-flat major, so that these first phrases sit on the open notes of the instrument. Instead of on Fs, which it was originally. I won't play it because I can't remember exactly what the notes were. So we altered that. We brought a few of them down an octave. Most of that was all right. The final bar, this one, was one that we definitely brought down an octave. Basically because it's so early in the concerto, I didn't want to go up ridiculously high. Which is hard to get, fits in well with the first bit. So I took the aim down, and it doesn't affect the lyrical line in it at all. It doesn't really alter too much of the original material, so it's still there, but down an octave. The next section is one that we did butcher up a little bit. The original part was up an octave, and it also went like this. And it was just too high. The flexibility is of moving from the top C sharp, which is a concert pitch E on this instrument, or a concert pitch E, down to the bottom C, with them. It was just too hard, I thought, for the instrument, for my own playing as well, would be too difficult. So I took a few examples of how we could do it. So the first variation on that would have been to play all the octave going. And we could have put a little bit of an accent on this third beat to get that drop, so. Or we could have just left it as it was. And I think that that rhythmic sort of sense is what Vivaldi was getting at, that he was wanting this little push. And it's showing off the fast playing that the bassoon's capable of achieving. And showing off again that perky, sort of narrow sound. The other version could have just been taking the quavers and go. Take the octave jumps and the jumps that move down to the lowest notes. And we lose a lot of energy, we lose a lot of the notes doing that, and it wouldn't have been. This concerto pushes forward all the time, and it would have just pulled that back too much, I thought. So the next version would have been take it all down an octave. And since we have rehearsed it, I think that might be a better option doing the one that we kind of done in a few bars. Most of the bars feature like that, they're all just down an octave from what they were. The opening three, four bars don't, but the rest of them all do. And again, it was to do with jumps, that top E natural down to the bottom C is quite a jump, and although we can practice it, practice flexibilities, it'll be a little bit difficult. But you do get a sense, that note, the lower ones, is a sort of added accent. These ones might be down an octave as well. So what we done was we just made it so we could set the first three bars, set tempo up, set the sort of feel up, and then we started to diverge them a little bit. So the actual one that we used in the arrangement was this one. And then we've got these scales. And I really struggled to get them together, so just last night got the piano to play them, but they're up in the correct octave. I wanted to try and, for a player that's capable of doing it, to be able to do the jump. A little bit more rehearsal than we got them. And it'd be quite impressive, but just never quite got them fully up to the rehearsal speed or the performance speed that was required. So last night we got piano to play them, but that's not any disadvantage to the concerto itself. There was, in the period that Vivaldi was writing, it was perhaps quite a normal thing to swap parts around. So the bassoon player would actually play in the first 14 bars as part of the ensemble, and then they'd have his own little line, and then he'd play sometimes as part of the ensemble. But so we've kind of been influenced by that a bit and thrown a few bars around. So we get that change, we've got the tuba down the octave, good, da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da- rig-a-dig-a-dum, bing-bong, bing-bong. And it just brought that bit together a little bit nicer than what it was playing it on the tuba. So that could just be bad writing on my part. Could have taken them down an octave, but then it starts to go a bit too low. And then this last one, we'd have to then go back up, so we'd have to go. So that bar 51, we've kept it as written because it sounds quite nice to go back up. That's the way that phrase works quite well, and then back up as the original material I had. Next phrase was completely as written, sits well. I think I brought it down an octave. I mean, brought something else down an octave that's similar. And the next phrase again is exactly the same. And again, this bit's a little bit tricky to play, and I don't think we ever quite got it fully when we performed it to the speed that was required. So that was all. That takes us up to there. The next phrase is written to go. And those rising scales started to get a bit higher towards the end, so I dropped them down the octave, which still keeps the same shape, but it actually gives it a bit more character, I think, down the octave playing. And then the piano I used for the second parts, because these parts are doubled up, so the bassoon goes da 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 down the octave, and that changing colour, what I've done, was use the piano. And then I think it's in the left hand of the piano, they've got bum 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 ba da da, and it gives this antiphonal effect that the two parts are playing together quite well. So that was that section, it got a bit high, so I took it all down and that helped out. Then the last bit was fine the way it was. And That's got trill on the end. So I'm going to go back just a little bit. So this section originally had trills on it. And what I've felt with the trills, it just kind of clouded, it was quite hard to play. On the tuba with the mechanics of the way that it works, and it's quite a large instrument, so getting all that material through for just a quaver, a dotted quaver, which is a bit too much. So I've kept the original stately sort of melody, bom, borom, borom, bim, borom, borom, bom, borom, borom, bom, borom, borom. And it just keeps it there as it should be, or as it sort of intends. I don't think we lose anything from taking those trills out. We lose obviously the feeling that's sort of showing off. But on the bassoon, it's the keys are on the side, and it's a bit easier to get the different shapes of the notes out than it is with the tuba. The only other phrase I'm going to look at just now, and then we talk a little bit about Sibelius, is this first phrase. So we've got and this C goes up the octave, it jumps two octaves. And then obviously onwards. So I brought that down just to sit in with the melody a little bit more. It is possible to do it. It was originally a D that I jumped up to, or sorry, an F. So that E natural there was originally. And just to fit in with the surrounding material, it worked a little bit better down the octave. So, in review of this arrangement, now that we've finished with all the bits that we've changed in it, I don't think it worked entirely well on the tuba. We played it, and I'm sure you'll be able to see the performance of it on YouTube, and just looking back on it, it was really hard, a really difficult piece to get pull off playing. I didn't quite, for this project, ever reach that standard that would be able to properly performable in public. It's really tricky. There's lots of tricky shapes in it, lots of tricky jumps, lots of tricky intervals, and we've done our best to try and bring up the rehearsals towards it and spent a lot of time on it, but unfortunately just never really got there. And I think maybe the working of it would possibly better suit to the euphonium in the way that it's written, and a lot of the bassoon work does transfer across quite well into the euphonium. There's various arrangements of other bassoon concertos for brass bands with euphonium, and I think that might have been a better idea to maybe have arranged it for that, not the tuba. It's a bit too heavy, it's a bit too difficult to get around those notes. A bit more time and maybe we could have got up to the rehearsal speed, or the performance speed that I'd like, but it just didn't really work. And it's another example, we use a lot of software now, and it sounds quite alright on the software, but actually playing up the instrument was quite tricky. So that's something always to watch out for when we're writing things, I think now, going forward, is to actually think of the mechanics of playing it, because put stuff in it, Sibelius, hit play, and that'll computerise, the computer can play the stuff back, but playing it back on the instrument's a lot more difficult. So that's just a few of the thoughts on the bassoon concerto, a few of the arrangement techniques we used, and how kind of we preserved as much of it as we possibly, as I think we possibly could. There could have been some other areas where we preserved it a bit more, but I'm quite happy with how we ended up with the product, and done our best with it.